To be honest, I don't know how cooperative he's gonna be in today's video. He might be very cooperative, he might not. We're gonna try this, right? We're gonna try this. We are doing his 6-month update. I showed you guys, if you did not see it, click this card here. When I was still in the hospital with him, I said that I want to come back in 6 months and do an update. And I did not forget my promise. But here he is, a big old nugget. Oh my goodness, he's a whopper. Look at him. Oh my goodness, he's so chunky wonky. Oh, he's so squishy. You guys, I miss having squishy babies. I forget how squishy they are, and I love it. I love cuddling with him. I love just squishing him. Oh, you're so squishy. Anyways, today, we are here to do a 6-month update, and that includes a few different things. It includes me showing you some of the items that we cannot live without. There was a lot of challenges that came with starting from conception all the way through 6 months after birth that we had to overcome. If you don't know the story, if you may be new to my channel or didn't keep updated with like my pregnancy diaries, we had a hard time getting pregnant with my second child, Hunter. My daughter is right now with her Mimi. We had a really hard time getting pregnant with him. It took just over a year to get pregnant with him. The pregnancy was pretty rough. It was pretty normal in the beginning, but dealt with lots of morning sickness. I mean, like bed rest morning sickness. And that's not easy to do when you have a toddler who was in school at the time. I had like tooth issues. I had to get like a root canal and filling done during my pregnancy. Like I just have had to overcome a lot of challenges. And then the delivery was not super easy. I ended up being induced on his due date. His birthday is January 29th, 2020. He was born on that date, which was his due date, like I said, and I had to get induced. I was so incredibly uncomfortable. I just needed the pregnancy to be over. And so I got induced and he was born, but he had the cord wrapped around his neck. So he kind of got stuck, like literally stuck halfway out. So it was not only incredibly painful for me, but he came out not breathing at first and the doctor cut the cord and everything. And thank the Lord every single day that I have this little miracle with me. Oh, he just woke up from a nap. I feel it's just so cute. So I am beyond blessed to have him with me today, but he's a really good baby, but we had to overcome certain challenges, especially with sleeping and feeding. I attempted to breastfeed again with him, but it was not producing enough milk, which was my issue with Ella. So we breastfed a couple of times, but he was like constantly hungry and he wasn't getting what he needed. He's very active, by the way, so he's gonna be all over the place this entire video. So he was not getting enough food, so I was getting really stressed out. I ended up switching to formula, which I don't think there's anything wrong with that, but I had really wanted to try to breastfeed and it wasn't for me. It didn't work for me, and that's okay. So I had challenges that came along with that. And then I fell into a really pretty bad depression where I was struggling with my mental illness. I just had a baby, and I know it's like postpartum depression is a very real thing. I did suffer with it. I don't think I'm like totally out of it. I've been going to like counseling for that, but that's a different video. So I had my mental health challenges, and then we also had challenges with his sleeping. I think I made the mistake about not putting him in the crib immediately when I got home. He first slept in a swing because he was still getting up every 2 hours, so he was like right next to our bed. The bassinet that I had, we used that a little bit, but like he would sleep for like 5 minutes, if that. Most of the time he would fall asleep in my arms, and then he would, like, as soon as I transferred him to the bassinet that I got, I would like transfer him sleeping, and pretty much as soon as I transferred him, he'd be like wide awake and screaming and stuff. And this went on for months and months and months, so I kept putting him back in the swing. I talked to my pediatrician about it too, because I had concerns, and they basically said do whatever I gotta do. And so he slept in the swing for a while, but in the back of my mind, like, I knew I wanted to get him out of the swing as soon as possible. So there was one day where I was just so fed up not being able to get him to sleep in anything but the swing. I would put him in the crib and he would roll over, and I'm like, what am I gonna do? So I did a little bit of research, and I ended up finding, I'm gonna show you guys the first essential. What are you doing, honey? I'm gonna show you guys the first essential that I got, and maybe actually I'm gonna try to lie him down next to me too, maybe with a toy to keep him preoccupied for a minute. You okay? Hi. I ended up going to Target, and this thing was pretty pricey, but it's from Lullyboo. I've shown this in a vlog, but it's this bassinet. And this is the only thing that I had been able to successfully get him to sleep in. So we put it in his crib, but he sleeps in this. It does come with toys, which we flip up at night so he can't access them. Like, they're not coming off anyways. There's no long strings or anything. But it's pretty cool. This is a removable canopy as well. I'll show you guys. And it velcros in the... velcros in the back. And then it actually folds. I think you can just fold it up like this. It has two clips, which I will demonstrate. It has two clips, and then it also has, like, it turns into a little backpack. So it's great for traveling too. So when we're planning on taking, like, a camping trip, so that's definitely useful that it compacts like that. So I would definitely recommend, if you're having trouble having your child, your infant, maybe transition from a swing, or even if they sleep, like, on your chest to a bassinet, maybe try that one. And unfortunately, I had to do the cry it out method once. There was one day I was so frustrated about not being able to get him sleep. I had done my research, I got this bassinet, it still wasn't working. I went on Google and I just searched, like, how do you get your child to sleep on his own? And someone recommended the cry it out method, and they, like, kind of gave you tips. They said, like, set a timer for like 15-20 minutes, go and check on him, make sure he didn't, like, soil himself, make sure he didn't spit up or, like, something like that. He's too hot, too cold, whatever. So I did that one time. I set a timer for 20 minutes, and I think it took maybe 15 minutes of crying for him to finally fall asleep. And ever since, he's been able to soothe himself to sleep, and I'm not pulling my hair out. And I wanted to avoid the method because I just thought that it was kind of mean to let your kid cry. But at the same time, I didn't feel like I was doing him any good running in there every 2 minutes, because he was never going to be able to learn how to self-soothe himself. So I did the best thing that I thought as a parent for my child that might be different for you. But I'm happy with what I did, because now it's so much different. I'm not crying every day trying to get him to nap. He takes 2 naps a day. He practically sleeps through the night. He's still up once a night, but he's actually been waking up, like, between 4 and 5 a lot, sometimes 2 and 3, but he's only up once a night. And if he's up twice a night, all it takes is the first time, if it's too early, to put a pacifier in, and he falls asleep again within 5 minutes. So I think that one time of just buckling down and sobbing, just absolutely sobbing, knowing my child was crying and I was kind of ignoring him, it took that one time, and ever since he had no issue. So I felt like I did the right thing, and he didn't even take the full 20 minutes I set the timer for. So you're so content with that. So I'm gonna go through and show you guys some of the other stuff that I would definitely recommend, or helpful things that I found in my second pregnancy. I'll also show you a little bit of, he's moving and grooving a little bit. So I'll show you guys that toward the end of the video. So let's get into it. So obviously I just showed you the bassinet, which I think has been the biggest lifesaver. Now I might get questions about what kind of bottles I like to use, because I am using formula. I'll show you two. The first one, which had been my favorite all throughout my first pregnancy, was from the brand Avent. I really like these because the Dr. Brown ones and some of the other ones, they just have so many parts. You don't have time. You think you have time and you're like, I have a newborn, but it's fine. I'll get laundry done. I'll get dishes done. Like, stop kidding yourself like I did, please, seriously, because it was just a nightmare. So you want, like, to me, I wanted less parts of a bottle to clean every single time, especially since we're going through like 6 to 8 bottles a day. It was a nightmare. Unless you want to buy 1,000 bottles to keep on back, sure, you can do that, but it was just too much to keep up with. So these Avent ones have worked great, and you can just, like, change the nipple out as they need, like, a medium flow to, I don't know, after a certain months you want to change the nipple, so they get, like, more at a time gradually. But so that was, like, my first recommendation for a bottle. But then I found these bottles, which are actually breastfeeding bottles, and because they came with not only this and a cover for travel, but then they came with, like, a little screw for just this part, which I thought was really interesting. So you could pump and then store your milk with a cap on, not necessarily like a bottle cap, you know what I'm saying? But I absolutely love these. These were, like, the most successful bottles we tried with him. These are medium flows as well, and I think they're perfect for him at this age. They are a little bit wet. I just I washed them, but I would really recommend these. And these I found at Walmart. I picked up 2 packs, so I have 6 of them.
Hi, honey.
Kind of going back to the not being able to sleep, somebody recommended to me a white noise machine, and we had the AC running on in my bedroom, so I'm like, he's fine. Like, that is his white noise, but I didn't feel like it was enough. Yeah, it wasn't enough, so I picked up this at Target. This is from the brand My Baby. I'm trying to avoid putting stuff over here because of the window. I guess I'll scooch, but I need to keep my eye on you because you move everywhere. But this is from the brand My Baby, and it's exactly that. It's a white noise machine, so it has sounds. It's not plugged in, so I can't really, like, demonstrate, but it has sounds. It projects as well, so it have like a little slideshow kind of thing on the ceiling. But because we use that canopy, I don't even think he sees it. But we use an ocean sound, and this combined with the method of letting him cry it out has given us much better nights of sleep for both my husband and I. So I would really recommend it, and it really wasn't that expensive as well. I think it was under, well, maybe like 25. I was gonna say under 20, but I think it was 25 or something. But there were cheaper options as well. Bibs. What the heck is so special about bibs? Buy 1,000. Buy 1,000. You think you have enough bibs? You do not. Again, you're not really gonna have a whole time to do laundry. I do laundry literally every single day. But if your child is teething like mine is, it's waterworks. Just waterworks. Like, the saliva doesn't stop. He's constantly soaking through bibs. I'll have 10 clean bibs for the day, and I'm like, that's enough. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, no, 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 no. You need so many more than that. I'm not even just trying to be funny. I ended up buying 3 more packs of bibs, like 10 packs. 30 bibs more, because I was just so tired of running out of them, having to run down to the dryer and get them laundry every single day, you guys. So buy bibs, 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 bibs. It's always a fantastic baby shower gift. You know, if somebody is having a baby, buy them bibs. You think somebody else is gonna buy them bibs? Good, everybody needs to buy them bibs. Hi, I'm gonna show you guys just these. I think these are pretty standard in any baby. I'm sure most parents would know to buy teething rings. Can I see that one for 1 second? I'm gonna switch with you. You won't let go. You won't let go. Here you go. Ooh, that's a fresh one. That one's colder. Teething rings. I have a little cactus one he was just gnawing away on. Oh my goodness. By, I would say, 4 months. By like 4 months old, you want to get your baby teething rings. I throw mine in the refrigerator. I feel like when I put them in the freezer, they're too cold for him because he's like, he shakes so much with the ones from the freezer, so I give him the ones from the fridge instead, and I think they do wonders. He just broke his first tooth. I just found out yesterday, which for me, he also just turned 6 months yesterday, so not only was it half a year birthday, but it was also his very first tooth just broke through, so I was so excited. But I would really recommend this for teething. Oh my gosh, I have to get one more thing for teething too. You need to come with me because I don't trust that you won't roll off. This is the Zarbee's Baby Gum Massage Gel. Hold on, baby, I need it to focus. Focus, this, get this. If your store doesn't have it, get it on Amazon. This was a lifesaver, and I don't know, I feel like it worked. There were some days where he was just so fussy, like, and nothing was wrong, and I know that's a sign of teething when your baby's just like, fussy, they're uncomfortable. So I took a little bit, it says like a pea-sized amount, put it on his gums, and I just feel like he I just feel like he calmed down. I don't know. Did it work? Did that gel work? I don't know, but I truly thought it worked. So I would recommend again the teething rings, and I would also recommend picking this up. Now, what should we show them next? Pacifiers. My only daughter, never took to pacifiers, never really cared for them. I don't know how the heck we soothed her. I think she was really easy baby. She didn't really cry very much, but this one, I'll give you a new one. Mama's prepared. This one takes the pacifiers a lot, but I found these. Guys, these are glow-in-the-dark pacifiers. They're from the brand Nuke or Nook. I never really knew. But they glow in the dark. I have 2 different brands of pacifiers, but they're so cool. They actually glow, like the little handle glows like a bright green, which is amazing. If it's the middle of the night, you don't want to turn on any of the lights, but you need to put the pacifier back in their mouth, It's so easy to find because they're like bright neon green. His mouth, on the other hand, is harder to find. I may have poked him in the eye once or twice trying to get the pacifier back in, but at least I found the passy really easy. Thanks, Charlie. Hey, you want to sit? He's not like angry at it. Now, Hunter has been on solid food for a couple months now. I did like his first experience. It did take a little bit for him to really get accustomed to the cereal, but I ended up mixing his cereal and his vegetables together. So that way he has 3 vegetables a day, 1 without cereal and then 2 with cereal. And then he has like, dude, he has like 5 bottles. He keeps gagging himself, honey. And that is step 1, teether. And then he has about like 5 bottles a day. So I just wanted to share some of his favorites. The first one we had tried is the sweet potato. Oh my gosh, he's reaching for it. He knows what it is. This is the sweet potato. This is a 2-ounce container, which is the serving size I give him for his vegetables. I also have a pear, which is the first time today is the first time we've tried pear. He seemed to really like it. He's tried banana, he's tried green beans, peas, prunes, apple. Yeah, apple. I think that's it. Maybe carrot too. Ironically, is this one carrot? No, this is pumpkin. We have not tried pumpkin, but I was also showing they also have this one. And these are really easy to figure out what ones your baby need. This one's a little harder where it says... This one says stage 1, so you just kind of look for the numbers. I liked these better because on the container it shows you. These are for supported... Hello? We don't want to focus today, but this is for a supported sitter. This is right there. Come on. What are you focusing on? My cute little baby. That's what, there we go. Supported sitter right there. So I really like that. It just makes it really easy to know what stage... of food your baby needs. When he's sitting by himself, like he sits but he topples over. When he's sitting by himself, we'll also start being able to give him those little like dissolvable crackers, which I'm super duper excited about. The only reason I don't like these as much as the other ones is because these are 4 ounces, so it's 2 servings.
Stop it.
There's 2 servings in one instead of just 1 serving. So I put it in the refrigerator when I'm done and then I use it like the same day. I'll use 1 jar for 2 out of 3 of his feedings. So I think that is everything. Oh, the last thing I wanted to show you guys, I'm sorry. I only had the pink one. Are you okay with that? He wants it. No, you're gonna choke yourself with it. If you're choking yourself with this, what do you think you're gonna do with this? I don't think so. I had showed not a pink one, but in his first feeding video, I showed you guys some babe. Here, take the cactus back, please. I showed you guys the spoons that color change. So if you heat up your baby's food, you could either serve it at room temperature or you can either serve it at room temperature or you can heat it up. So if you do heat it up, these spoons actually, I'm gonna lie you back down, baby. These spoons actually color change, so they'll turn white. I'm keeping my hand on you. They'll turn white if they're too hot. Where was all this stuff 5 years ago when I was pregnant? No. Oh my gosh. No, almost 7 years ago because she's turning 6. Oh, yikes. Your shirt is soaked. But yeah, I thought that was really cool too. So if your baby is starting on solids, I think a lot, if not all baby spoons are starting to do that, the color change thing. So I think they'd be really, really easy to find if you're interested. All right, so those were all my newborn essentials. Hopefully I'm not missing anything. Maybe I'll do like another year update. I mean, you guys see him in my vlogs and I talk about my kids all the time. So yeah, so it's not like we're not gonna see you, is it? But I'm gonna show you guys a little bit about what he's doing on the floor. I'm also probably gonna do like a side-by-side because I showed my body basically right after my birth. And although I don't really feel like super comfortable showing my body now, it's like back to normal. So I was just gonna do a side-by-side comparison from what I was literally right after birth to where I am 6 months later body-wise, and I'll show you a little bit about what he's doing on the floor. Yeah! Holy crap, I almost just broke my camera. Give me that shirt. Here. My time for Debbie. Just a second. Hi. He's on his mat right now. Give me that shirt. All right, let me show you guys real quick, like a side-by-side, I guess, comparison from 6 months ago. Basically, my stomach. But I am pretty much back to normal. I've actually lost a lot of weight. I'm a little thinner than I would like to be, thinner than I was when I got pregnant. That's due to like a whole different issue, but I'm pretty much back to normal. I did not get any stretch marks, like new stretch marks from this pregnancy. I had stretch marks right here from my first pregnancy, but I'll do like a little 360 kind of thing. Hi, honey. But yeah, there's an awkward 30 seconds. All right, moving on. I gotta be quick because he's very quick on his feet. So I'm just gonna show you a little bit about what he's been doing. Oh my gosh, I think I ruined my Zoom thing. Oh no! Okay, I'll fix that later. But he is definitely not, he's not crawling. He's for sure rolling over, which I'm surprised he hasn't done yet. I want to get rid of those. He usually crawls over the second he's put on the ground. Let me see if he'll do it. Oh yeah, so he rolls like a champ. So we're practicing getting up crawling. So again, he's not crawling yet, but he's getting his full chest and head off of the ground. He has the idea to get his knees under him. I wonder if he's gonna do it or not. Usually he does. What you doing, honey? You got it? Are you trying to roll over again? I think he's just trying to get up. He does it better on like the solid. Oh, see, so he's pushing. He knows what he's gotta do. He's just not quite there yet. So, but we're getting super duper close, but he does roll. Like if I leave him there for a minute, he'll be over there in 2 seconds. So you really have to be careful. He just kind of rolls everywhere. Even when I put him on the couch, I have to be right there. I even keep my hands on him half the time or a leg in front of him or something because I don't trust him. Wait, honey. But that is my 6 month update for my little nugget. We cut our tooth. We're about to crawl. Oh my goodness. Yeah, push baby, push. Let me wiggle this out from under you, sweetie. So maybe we can try. Here, let's wiggle this out for a second. Give him kind of like a more solid surface to try to crawl on or push up on. Oh, come on, baby. You got it, Bubby. We're definitely getting there, you guys. Oh, push, 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 watch your head. Oh, boink. You okay? Look good. Look good. It's so much work. You look like a prince. Oh, God. Okay. All right. All right. Too much pressure on the belly. But anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed our 6 month update. Let me turn you around so you can see. Hi, honey. I hope you guys enjoyed our 6 month update. Hi, baby. I cannot believe it's been half a year. I always forget, like in the moment, you're like, this will never end. I'll never get sleep again. But then 6 months go by and you're like, oh, that actually wasn't so bad. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy, please go ahead, leave a thumbs up. Also, while you're down there, hit that subscribe button. Also, check out my second channel because quite frankly, I've been posting more on there than I have on here recently. So I love you guys so much and I'll see you in my next one. Bye. Thank you, bye. Oh, I forgot to mention he loves that noise. Oh, I wonder if I can get him to laugh. I guess he's laughing like crazy too. I'll insert a quick video of him laughing with Ella in the backseat of a car. It was the cutest thing and I can't get him to laugh right now. So love you guys. Mwah. Bye. Love yours. I check out the bottom. I can't go for the second. I can't go for the second. I said, Bob. Check out the bottom. Oh, God. I go for the second. Yeah,
Thank you, Mojito Bagotito.